Come on in.
Tilt down.
Oh, he's weird looking.
Get him to shake off that dirt. I want to see the pizza.
This one is a little bit more
dirtier.
Dirty. Yeah, a little crustier than yesterday.
It's got something in its nose.
It's in his mouth. Or his
mouth.
You know, I think I may have enjoyed it more before we zoomed in that much.
Yeah, this shimmer's
killer,
huh?
It's a little crustier, and it's a mini pizza. See?
Oh, my God.
I made a joke. I didn't even realize
Dev, stop.
Okay, pulling out four full. Those things on its back are, I don't know, for better words, exhaust holes.
Oh, that's cool. I'll tilt down just a touch.
So the thing on its nose, between the eyes, is actually a little lure. This is in the same group of fish as the anglerfish. But the batfish have a very short lure, and it generally points out or downwards, and the mouth is on the underside of the body.
You guys saw it, I was
so the batfish feed on little crustaceans and things that live in the substrate, in the sediment, instead of luring things in from the water, like the bigger anglerfish do.
They
thought that maybe this lure has a chemical function that it can actually produce some chemicals that might lure out little crustaceans and things for feeding. You can see the nostrils on each side of the lure, and then the eye kind of behind the nostrils. So they're anglerfish relatives, but they use a different mode of feeding than most of the anglerfish.
So, Bruce, where exactly is the lure?
That thing you guys got grossed
the little, out about. Yeah, the little thing in the it's in the hole.
It's the sort of three-lobed, kind of brownish or greenish structure in
looks
the
like
hole
salt.
In the snout between the nostrils. The nostrils are the two rimmed sort of reddish things, and then you can see the eye up behind there.
Yep.
So instead of having the lure out on a long, modified dorsal fin ray like the goosefish that we were seeing on earlier dives, or like the frogfish have, this one has a short one in the hole in the snout.
Yeah.
Might be able to stick that out a little bit, but not very much. So it's feeding on smaller benthic animals.
Yeah, very
I'm
cool.
Sure we get lasers.
Honestly, I thought that was some sediment. It had gotten up its nose.
As well as there's an ophiroid to the right, what looks like a piece of a nautilus shell, perhaps, in front. Crinoids all around.
Full wide.
There we go. Laced. Okay. Take it off. Yeah, we're just going to skip it for the next two dives while the tilt is broken.
Yeah, copy that. How's that or more?
More. And current doesn't seem very strong out here. I'm just sort of...
I love it. Zoom more! Look at him. Oh,
wow.
Brilliant.
I don't know.
Can you zoom more?
You got it?
What kind of fish is this?
The family is Oncocephalidae.
I don't know. I mean,
no, I don't think
so. The tongue fish we saw earlier was very different looking. It actually did have the shape of a tongue.
So this is a different species than before, we're thinking.
Yeah, and actually, this isn't a tongue fish because that was a type of sole, and it had both eyes on one side of its head. And this fish does not.
I'm pretty sure these are bat fish.
This fish has an eye on each side of its head,
fish.
Right?
So Brian Green just said, this is a bat fish.
How cool is this? This fish looks like it's ready for Halloween already.
You want to go in tight pattern on his back?
Why can't it just dress like that all the time?
It can, but I mean, it's got orange and black.
Let's get a tight zoom here, and then I'll pick up and move around.
I know, this is just great.
Oh, is that it? Okay.
So...
All right, let's zoom out, and I'll move around. See if I can do it without scaring him off.
And Scott Francis said, that is one tricked out fish, and I could not agree more.
That's why I was wondering what those things are. Like, why does it have all those different patterns
on it? So Brian's just replied to your question and said that it's likely either for sensory purposes, and I'm going to assume...
Don't assume anything. But so for sensory purposes or for camouflage?
He means the little, perhaps the little projections off the sides are for sensory purposes, whereas the color pattern is for camouflage, maybe?
Yeah, 30 more which, seconds. I mean, to be honest, we're in this very reddish-orange sediment. Couldn't have picked a better place to try to camouflage here.
Oh, walking. Oh, look at those. Whoa, wow. Crazy.
The ship has about 8 more meters
to
go.
Oh, wow.
But
he's turning his back to us.
Flat ahead, yeah. So this is worth it.
Okay, this is like even weirder than most of the other ones we've seen walking.
Did all the others have those two siphon valves things on the back?
Where?
That opened.
I didn't see that. I'm sorry. Yeah.
All right, pilot, I am getting past.
No, I didn't. Okay.
Opened as he shows off.
Yeah.
It's like jet propulsion?
Is it still moving or we stop?
It's got like 8 more meters.
Okay.
But I think,
I'll zoom out ahead when we're done.
I have this feeling that Brian is listening to us back on shore and laughing hysterically as he attempts to tell us what is really happening here.
He's walking off. Yes.
Can we zoom out of here? Yeah, right there.
It reminds me of a cat.
Really?
I don't know why. The way it walks.
Never had a cat.
Okay.
The way it walks. Yeah. Okay, right. See, Jim's with me.
I disagree. I'm totally not in with this.
I'm just going to move a little faster.
So you can clearly see why it's named the batfish. It looks just like a bat.
Oh, yeah.
I could turn around.
Just keep it there.
All right.
It's pretty flat. I'll zoom out.
Copy.
Exactly. What bats have you been looking at?
Right, two more seconds.
So Brian said he doesn't like the ROV. He's trying to get away. I think that was about the kindest thing that Brian could have said to us, as opposed to what is wrong with all of you people for saying such stupid things about this fish.
And then Scott has speculated that, you know, the little sort of projections on the all around the body could be something that other animals attempt to nibble on.
Coming forward, Sean.
And then it turns around and snaps them up.
Yeah.
We didn't hit the lasers on there.